Please be seated, everyone. Thank you. Hello, thank you all for joining us on this special day. Today, we honor the love Catherine and Dominic have for one another and bear witness to the commitment they have shared toward one another and will continue to share from now until eternity. Dominic and Katie would like me to thank all of you for being here and recognize how immensely important each of you are to them. They would also like to recognize all of those who could not make it here or could not be here. They are missed, but certainly not forgotten. For those of you who don't know me, I'm John, Katie's brother, and today's officiant of the ceremony. I felt incredibly lucky that Katie and Dominic asked me to be their officiant for their wedding. One of these two people before me is the most beautiful, gallant, radiant, pleasant person I've ever known. And the other's Katie. My siblings and I have grown up with parents who share unimaginable amounts of love and passion for their family and for each other. And that is reflected in how myself and my sisters treat those around us. Even when my mother would drive Katie and I around town, and Katie would punch me in the arm and yell, "Ah, John, stop it!" I still had nothing but love for her. And now I know, Dom, that even when Katie is driving you up a wall, asking her to make you another coffee, you'll have that same love for her too. Marriage gives permanence and structure to a couple's love. It is the way to tell one another that no matter how bossy they can be, or how often you leave the cabinet doors open, we are still in this together. In marriage, the little things are the big things. It is remembering to say, "I love you," at least once a day. It is speaking words of appreciation and demonstrating gratitude in thoughtful ways. It is having the capacity to forgive and forget. It is giving each other an atmosphere in which each can grow. It is a common search for the good and for the beautiful. It is not only marrying the right partner, but also being the right partner. I'd like to read a poem by George Eliot called "To Be With One, To Be One With Each Other." What greater thing is there than two human souls, than to feel that they are joined together, to strengthen each other in all labor, to minister to each other in all sorrow, to share with each other in all gladness, to be with each other in the silent, unspoken memories. I now want to invite my sister to speed read through a poem.
Yeah, I will do my best.
Yeah.
Marriage is a commitment to life, the best that two people can find and bring out in each other. It offers opportunities for sharing and growth that no other relationship can equal. It is a physical and an emotional joining that is promised for a lifetime. Within the circle of its love, marriage encompasses all of life's important relationships. A wife and husband are each other's best friend, confidant, lover, teacher, listener, and critic. And there may come times when one partner is heartbroken or ailing, and the love of the other may resemble the tender caring of a parent or child. Marriage deepens and enriches each facet of life. Happiness is fuller, memories are fresher, commitment is stronger, even anger is felt more strongly, and it passes away much more quickly. Marriage understands and forgives the mistakes of life, is unable to avoid. It encourages and nurtures new life, new experiences, new ways of expressing a love that is deeper than life. When two people pledge their love and care for each other in marriage, they create a spirit unique unto themselves which binds them closer than any spoken or written words. Marriage is a promise, a potential mate in the hearts of two people who love each other and takes a lifetime to fulfill.
I'd now like to invite David, Dominic's grandpa, to read a prayer.
Lord, I ask you to bless Dominic and Kate. Give them wisdom and understanding so that they can accomplish the promises that they will make to each other today. Provide them with an abundance of love, passion, joy, and forgiveness so that their marriage will prosper. Dominic and Kate, from this day forward, you are all you need. You have each other.
Thank you.
you that.
Dominic and Katie, the vows that you are about to make are a way to show your love and commitment to each other. Dom, would you please repeat after me? I, Dominic, take thee, Catherine, to be my wedded wife.
Take thee, Catherine, to be my wedded wife.
To have and to hold from this day forward.
To have and to hold from this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer, for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
Love and to cherish.
Till death do us part.
Till death do us part.
And till rain do us part.
Keep going.
Katie, would you please repeat after me? I, Catherine, take thee, Dominic, to be my wedded husband. To have and to hold from this day forward. For better or for worse. For richer or poorer. In sickness and in health. To love and to cherish.
Until death do us part.
Catherine and Dominic will now exchange rings to symbolize their commitment. Rings start as unrecognizable, imperfect metals and are forged to create something where there was once nothing at all. It is customarily worn on the ring finger, the only finger with a vein running directly to the heart. The wearing of the rings is a visible outward sign that they have committed themselves to one another. Dominic.
Yes.
Please take Katie's hand and repeat after me. I give this ring to you.
I give this ring to you.
As a symbol of our love.
As a symbol of our love.
For today, tomorrow.
For today, tomorrow.
And for all the days to come.
And for all the days to come.
You shall not walk alone.
You shall not walk alone.
My heart will be your shelter.
My heart will be your shelter.
And my arms will be your home.
And my arms will be your home.
Katie, please take Dominic's hand and repeat after me. I give you this ring as a symbol of our love.
I give you this ring as a symbol of our love.
For today, tomorrow, and for all. Not walk alone. My heart will be your shelter.
My heart will be your shelter.
And my arms will be your home.
My arms will be your home.
Catherine and Dominic, you have professed your love by exchanging your vows. You have symbolized your commitment by exchanging rings. With rain on its way, we're going to skip the obstacle course, the couple's obstacle course, and proceed right to the final part of the ceremony, the I do's.
Thank God.
Catherine, do you take Dominic to be your husband? Do you promise to love him, comfort him, honor and keep him, in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, to be faithful to him as long as you both shall live? And Dominic, do you take Catherine to be your wife? Do you promise to love her, comfort her, honor and keep her, in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, be faithful to her as long as you shall live?
I do.
By the power vested in me by the Church of Life in Seattle, Washington, I now pronounce you husband and wife. Dom, you may kiss the bride. It is my pleasure to introduce Mr. and Mrs. Dominic Brown.